حبیب خدا ختم الانبیاء آواز بلند صلوات
اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد. اعوذ
بالله من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام والتحية والإكرام على حبيب إله العالمين سيدنا ونبينا وشفيع نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا الذي سمي في السماء بأحمد وفي الأرض بأبي القاسم المصطفى محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
ثم الصلاة والسلام والتحية والإكرام على آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المعصومين المنتخبين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وفرقانه الحميد وهو أصدق القائلين، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وقرن في بيوتكن ولا تبرجن تبرج الجاهلية الأولى، وأقمن الصلاة وآتين الزكاة وأطعن الله ورسوله، إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم رجس أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
Mawlaya sahib al-asr wa al-zaman, my dear elders, brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I would like to start today's majlis, inshallah, by asking you all a question. Who is Fatima Zahra? Once a scholar explained this in a very beautiful way. He said, look, a son is a blessing, a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But a daughter is a mercy, a rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for her parents. Now let me narrate to you 5 or 6 more traditions, and inshallah at the end we will draw a conclusion. So another hadith of the Holy Prophet is that in the Battle of Khandaq, when Imam Ali alayhi salam was going to fight against Amr bin Abdiwad, and everything depended on that battle of Imam Ali alayhi salam, the Holy Prophet said, "Baraz al-Imanu kulluh ila al-kufri kulluh." He said the entirety of Iman has confronted the entirety of disbelief or kufr. Another hadith of Rasulullah is that a man's Iman is not complete until he is married. So only when he is married is then his faith complete. Another hadith of the Holy Prophet is that a feet of a mother are paradise, a jannat for her children. Another hadith of the Holy Prophet is that Al-Hasan wal-Husayn sayyida shababi ahl al-jannah. An ayah of the Quran says that, O Rasulullah, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Prophet of Allah, we have not sent you apart so that you can be a mercy upon mankind. Now, my brothers and sisters, if you put 2 and 2 together, you will see that a daughter is a rahmah for her father. Rasulullah is rahmatul lil alameen. Fatima is therefore a rahmah upon rahmatul lil alameen. Ali is the entirety of Iman, but a man's Iman is not complete until he is married. Fatima therefore completes the Iman of Kul Iman. Hassan and Hussein are Sayyida Shabab Ahli Jannah. So here, my brothers and sisters, my Jannah and your Jannah and all of the Mu'mineen and Mu'minat's Jannah is at the feet of Hassan and Hussein. But Hassan and Hussein's Jannah is at the feet of Fatima. So now, brothers and sisters, how can it be possible to describe a lady who's a rahmah upon rahmatul lil alameen, who completed the iman of kul iman, whose feet are jannah for sayyida shababi ahlil jannah? You tell me, brothers and sisters, how can we even begin to fathom who such a lady is? But today I would like to share with you only one aspect of how great this holy lady is, and that is embedded in her name, Al-Mubarakah, the blessed one. It is narrated from Sheikh Saduq that Fatima possesses 9 names in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This sentence itself is enough, because the station of accompanying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a station where you can't get any better than. The proof of this in the Holy Quran is the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, fi maq'adi sidqin 'inda malikin muqtadir. They are in a state of righteousness with a capable king. This station is the station of the name of Fatima Zahra. If this is the holy, if the holy lady's names are at the level of accompanying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what say you about the character of Fatima Zahra alayhi salam? Now let me ask you a question. What are the names of Fatima Zahra? Yunus bin Ayman narrates that Fatima Zahra, that Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam has said,
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Fatima al-Zahra has 9 names in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Firstly, Fatima. Secondly, As-Siddiqah, the honest one. Thirdly, At-Tahira, the virtuous one. Fourthly, Az-Zakiyyah, the chaste one. Fifth, Ar-Radiyyah, the one who is pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sixth, Al-Mardiyyah, the one who will be satisfied by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seventh, Al-Muhaddatha, a person other than Rasulullah who angels used to converse with. 8th, Al-Zahra, the splendid one. 9th, Al-Mubarakah, the blessed one. He then continued, do you know what Fatima means? I replied, oh my master, relate it to me. He then replied, the one separated from every type of filth. He then continued, if the commander of the faithful, Ali ibn Abi Talib, was not created, then there would be no match for Fatima al-Zahra in the entire creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Adam alayhi salam till the day of judgment. It is also narrated in other traditions that she was named Fatima because she and her adherents, her Shia, would be separated from the fire of hell. It is also narrated that her name Fatima originates from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name Al-Fatir, which means the originator. She is named At-Tahira because she was purified from all filth and error, and also because she never witnessed the blood of menstruation at childbirth. She was named Az-Zahra because her light shone 3 times a day for Imam Ali alayhi salam. About Abu Hashim Al-Ja'fari relates that I asked Imam Hassan Al-Askari alayhi salam, he said, I asked Imam Hassan al-Askari why Fatima was named as Zahra. Imam replied, the illuminated countenance of Sayyida Fatima shone for Imam Ali 3 times daily. In the beginning of the day, similar to the shining sun. And at the time of early evening, similar to the radiant moon. Whilst at sunset, it would shine and it would resemble the glowing stars. Shaykh Saduq relates from Imam Ali al-Ridha that alayhi salam, that he said, when the moon of Ramadan shines in the sky, the light of Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra would prevail upon the light of the moon and would conceal it. The moon would only be visible when Bibi Fatima al-Zahra was not present. For today's majlis, inshallah, we will only be discussing the name Al-Mubarakah, the Blessed One, very briefly, and we will only touch upon 1 of 10 viewpoints in total. Al-Mubarakah is a name that God set for Bibi Fatima al-Zahra. And the blessing that I want to share with you today is embodied in the tasbeeh of Fatima al-Zahra. It is narrated that if one performs the tasbeeh of Fatima al-Zahra after every wajib prayer, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala endows upon him countless blessings from increased rizq to better health. But suffice it for the merits of this tasbih, one tradition of our 6th holy imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq has narrated to have said that reciting the tasbih of Bibi Fatima al-Zahra every day after every wajib prayer is more beloved to me and is greater than 1,000 units of prayer every single day. To understand this, one must first examine this tradition in a little more depth. Imam is saying, not equal to but better than this 1,000 units of salah. Of course, he is referring to mustahab salah, not wajib salah. But let's ponder on this for a moment. Salah is the ascension is the mi'raj of a believer, is it of a mu'min. Each unit of salah has within it one surah al-hamd. Each surah al-hamd is equivalent to one whole recitation of the Qur'an, according to verse 87 of chapter number 15 of the Holy Qur'an, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa laqad ataynaka sab'an min al-mathani wal-Qur'an al-Azim. And above all, who is saying this? Imam al-Insi wal-Jinn, Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq. Imam al-Sadiq's 1,000 rak'ah salah with 1,000 surat al-hamz, which in itself is equivalent to 1,000 entire recitations of the Holy Qur'an. And with 1,000 ruk'us by Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq himself, with 2,000 sujood. And the traditions tell us that the believer is at his closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he's in a state of sujood. Again, whose sujood are we talking about here? Imam al-Sadiq's. All of this on one side of the scale. And one tasbeeh, Habibi Fatima Zahra, by Imam al-Sadiq on the other side of the scale, is greater and more beloved to our Imam. What is truly astonishing is that Imam alayhi salam does not say how much greater this tasbeeh is than the 1,000 rak'ah salah. Can you see the benefits? Can you see the blessings in just one tasbeeh, Habibi Fatima al-Zahra? But the blessings encompassed within her character of al-Mubarakah do not end here. Today, if we are seated here in a gathering of her remembrance, this is also the barakah of the Holy Lady al-Mubarakah. If we will eat today from the niyaz, this is also her barakah. Is it not amazing, my brothers and sisters, that those loaves of bread that the Holy Lady gave in charity for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue and still feed her Shia, and the believers will continue to feed the believers till the Day of Judgment and beyond. Yes, by Allah, this is that glorious Fatima, the one who is most beloved to the heart of Rasulullah. Rasulullah only asked the Muslims for one thing after his death, to show love and affection to his Ahlul Bayt. Instead, they returned his favours by burning the door of the house of his most beloved Fatima. But that was not enough for them. The Mal'oon says, when I sense that Fatima is behind the burning door, I push the door with my leg so hard until I heard her bone shatter. They killed Mohsen. They tied her husband by the neck and dragged him in the streets of Medina. But time finally came when she reunited with her father Rasulullah on days like these. I ask you, my brothers and sisters, how hard must it have been for Amirul Mu'mineen to give her ghusl and shroud her in her kafan? Asma narrates that while me and Ali were giving Fatima her ghusl, there came a moment when Ali turned to the wall and screamed with a loud voice, "Ah!" When asked later, "Why did you do that, O Amirul Mu'mineen?" he replied, "I did not know the extent of her injuries, but when I felt the broken ribs, I realized how much pain she was in." Finally, Amir al-Mu'mineen called upon the children of Zahra to come and bid her farewell after shrouding her body. Amir al-Mu'mineen narrates that Imam Hassan, Lady Zainab and al-Kuthum all came and embraced their mother, but Imam al-Hussein refused to come in the room. Amir al-Mu'mineen asked his son, "Oh Hussein, why do you not want to bid farewell to your mother?" Hussein replied, "I will not come until my mother calls me herself." Amir al-Mu'mineen narrates that, "I swear by the one who holds power over my life, that I saw the shroud of Fatima open and her arms came calling out to her son, 'Come to me, my son Hussein.' A call came from the skies, 'Oh Ali, remove your children from their mother, for their pain has caused great grief and sorrow to the dwellers of the sky.' Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ala Muhammadin ayya munqalabi yanqalibun."
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad.